Back to our app, we have this gallery of contacts and we want to highlight the selected item. Basically, when I click in any of those items, I want the background's color to change based on the item that's selected. Right now, the only thing that differentiates if the item is selected is this lateral bar that we put here with this color, and it will show based on the isSelected property, as we already saw in previous lessons. Just remember, in the visible property of this rectangle, let me select the rectangle, we have the this item.isSelected, and it will be true only for the item that we click. Okay, based on this property, now we can change the background color. We have in the gallery one property that's called template fill. That means the background color of the template, of the line of the gallery. And it has this color right now that's just a transparent color. If I put white, for example, so color.white, everything will become white. But we can use conditionals here to change the color only for the selected item. So in this case, we could put the formula if to check if the item is selected. In this case, we can do like this. I will type if, open the parentheses, and then I will put the formula I want to test. I want to test if this item dot is selected. In this case, it will be true only for the item I click in the gallery. All the others will have false. And if this item.isSelected returns true, I want the template fill to be white. So let me put a comma and then put the color I want, that in this case is color.white. Okay. If it's not selected, I can choose another color or just close the parentheses here and it won't return anything. So it will just return if it's selected. But let's put a second option to be the color of the unselected item. I'll put a comma, and in case the condition returns false, it will skip this one, that's the true value, and it will go to the last option, that's the false value, as we already saw in the previous lessons about the if function. So in this case, let me put color dot, and then we have light gray, for example. That's a gray color, light gray. Okay, now we have this condition. It will show white for the selected and gray for the one that's not selected. Let's collapse the formula bar and play the app. We can already see that the first item in the gallery will have a different color from the others because this one is the current item that's selected. But if I click in any other item, it will change the color of that item and the first one will become gray in the template field because then the other item will be selected. So let me click right now in this one, Diana Prince. It will select that item and change the color. Okay, that's one feature that helps the user to identify which item is selected in the gallery. In the next video, I will be presenting you a gallery property that enables you to show an animation to the user when the user hovers the mouse over the gallery items. This is a very interesting feature because it provides the users a cue that the gallery is clickable, so the users understand that they can interact with the gallery. Given that, see you in the next video.